welcome back to the Ronnie Lee Show, you know what I'm saying? And we back out here in Hollywood, man. Frontline Productions with my man Carlos Lopez Jr. Y'all make sure y'all go ahead and show him some love. And tonight, you know what I'm saying, the NFL playoffs are back. I'm gonna give you my divisional round predictions, you know what I'm saying? Even though my record ain't doing too good in my picks, you know, I'm still gonna keep picking them for y'all, like I told y'all. And after that, man, we're gonna have a nice little discussion about this big, big movie I saw. Maybe one of the best movies of the year. You know what I mean? Hopefully your man get that good Oscar, you know what I'm saying? So y'all sit back, man, enjoy the show, you know what I'm saying? And first, you know what I mean, we're gonna get into it, man. AFC divisional round, man. Patriots versus the Broncos, man. Psycho Tom Brady versus Peyton Manning, man. This might be their last clash together too, man. And it's probably gonna be a good one, man. I'm hoping it's a big shootout like it always been, you know what I mean? And I think I'm gonna have to go just like last game, you know what I'm saying? Matter of fact, let's run through the game. Let's run through the scores for how it got there. First, the Patriots played the Chiefs, you know what I mean? And it was a good competitive game, you know what I mean? But like I said, like I told y'all last week, dog, until I see somebody whoop the Patriots, I'm not picking against them, dog. They're too perfect. They're the class of the league. They always where they supposed to be at. And, man, I'm just not picking against them. And as it proved last week, man, like the Chiefs played a good game, but they ain't got Psycho Tom out there, you know what I'm saying? Out there kirking on coaches and shit, kirking on the refs. You know what I'm saying? Psycho Tom. Until I see somebody beat him, dog, I'm just not picking against him. And what was the other AFC game? Steelers Broncos. And like, see, I would have picked the Steelers, dog. And they probably should have won this game for real. But the reason why I picked them last week is because they were so hurt. And I guess it came down to that in the end. You know what I mean? What was the score? 23-16. You know what I'm saying? Like, they just didn't have the firepower to pull out in the end, you know what I mean? But the Broncos won, you know what I mean? Their defense held up, and now, you know what I mean, they're going to the divisional round, so we'll see what happened. And then, you know, the best game of the whole joint, you know what I'm saying, to me, in my opinion, was the Packers and the fucking Cardinals game, dog. Your man, Aaron Rodgers almost pulled out another miraculous victory, dog. And that joint, and you know the crazy part about that game? Because I had to go do something, so I left like when the like fourth quarter started. And then all of a sudden I get to where I was, and everybody like, hey, dog, did you see the game and shit? You know what I'm saying? So I missed that, dog. So that night I went home and watched the little thing on YouTube, watched all the highlights. And it was a good game, dog. Like, the Packers, they had the receivers, but they people were stepping up, dog. Jeff Janis, big tall dude, dog. He was balling all game for real. You know what I mean? And big Eddie Lacy, you know what I'm saying, with the oatmeal cream pie stomach. You know what I'm saying? He bust that big ass run. And you know what I'm saying? I thought they was probably going to take the Cardinals out there, because I mean, even though the Cardinals, they talked about as a complete team, like, still, don't nothing really, like, jump out to me to them. You know what I mean? Like, don't nothing, like, wow me about them. They a good, solid team, and they got talent across the board. So, you know, they should win. You know, that's just my opinion about them. And then the game that I woke up, like, after, like, 4 hours, because, you know, that jump come on at 10 o'clock here in the West Coast. The fucking Carolina Seahawks game, dude. I got my ass up at 10 to watch that joint. And at first, I thought I was about to be disappointed, man. Carolina was blowing their ass way, way out in the first half. You know what I mean? Like, 31-0, that's usually game. That's skunk in the madness shit. You got past the sticks after that, you know what I'm saying? But they still Super Bowl champions, and they still was the reigning NFC champions. And they came back the second half, dog, made the game, you know what I mean? Like, it was kind of getting scary for the Panthers, but I told y'all, I'm a Killer Cam fan, like a style, so I was rooting for them no matter what, and I'm glad they're going to the divisional round, you know what I'm saying? And that's what it's going to be, man. So we got an AFC, we got Patriots, Broncos, NFC, Panthers, and Cardinals. And I'm going to start with the Panthers and Cardinals game. I told you, dog, I'm going with my man Killer fucking Cam, dog. Like, I don't know, it might be destiny, dog. And for real, when they took that L before the end of the season, that joint might have been a good thing, dog. It might have been something to get their focus right, like get them going, you know what I mean? And now that like, they on a collision course with Destiny, dog. You know what I'm saying? My man can't be dabbing in the motherfucking Super Bowl. You know what I'm saying? And I just don't think the Cardinals got that it factor like Cam and the Panthers got. You know what I mean? Like, it's a certain type of swag the Panthers got with them right now. You know what I mean? I don't know. It's a certain confidence that I think that's going to carry him through. And, Carson Palmer, he a good quarterback. You know what I mean? But he might still have them little demons. Last time he was in the playoffs, though, his motherfucking leg almost fell off. You know what I'm saying? So, we'll see how he handled that adversity, man. And, So, obviously, you know what I'm saying? Brady Peyton, dog. The Brady Peyton Bowl. That's going to be a good ass game, dog. You know what I mean? Like, I think both offenses are going to flourish. You know what I'm saying? Both of them are supposed to have good defense, but I think it's going to be an offensive game, dog. I think it's actually going to be a fairly high scoring game, actually, too. You know what I mean? So let's see. I'm going to pick a score of. Let's see. I'm gonna go Patriots 38, Broncos 35. You know what I'm saying? Patriots advance to the Super Bowl. This Peyton's last ride, and I believe he gonna. I don't think he gonna get hurt. I think he gonna last the whole game. But I just think Tom Brady and them are gonna make that one more extra play or kick that one field goal to go up by three. So 38-35, you know what I mean, is my score for that game. And for the NFC Championship game, I already told you I was going down. Now I'm going with my man Cam, dog. I'm going to go Cam and them 28-24, you know what I'm saying? My man Cam probably going to score all touchdowns. And the Panthers defense going to hold them to that one field goal. It's going to make the difference, man. So, yeah, man. I got the Carolina Panthers going to the Super Bowl. So that means it's going to be a rematch between the Patriots and the Panthers, dog. And that's going to be a delight, man. And like I said, Tom Brady, I respect everything, but I'm rooting for Killer Cam, man. I'm rooting for the Carolina Panthers to win this year's Super Bowl, you know what I'm saying? So those are my picks, you know what I mean? Y'all let me know in the comment section how y'all feel, man. Who's y'all picked to win the Super Bowl? And, you know, we're going to talk about it next week, you know what I'm saying? Now off to the next topic. And so Monday night, you know what I mean, I had a nice little night off and I went to go see that movie, The Revenant, you know what I'm saying? All the whole time since it's been out, man, it was the biggest hype movie. I had everybody telling me everything. Man, I had one bad person be like, yo, man, that motherfucking movie made me want to go out in the woods and learn how to be a man and shit. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? People were sizing it up, though. Like, man, it was the best fucking movie I've ever seen. You know what I'm saying? Then I had some critics that was like, man, it was alright, you know what I'm saying? That shit was kind of unrealistic. I had some people like, man, that's bullshit. Like, how the fuck you get attacked by a bear and all of a sudden you can still survive, you know what I mean? So, I heard so many things. I even got some of the parts spoiled on the gram because I'm looking through memes. They making memes of Leonardo and shit that gave up the movie. So, I was like, alright, if this joint popping so much like this, I'm going to have to go see the joint, you know what I'm saying? And then I got confirmation when my man Carlos told me that it was actually good. And he was telling me things to watch out for, like little certain things, you know what I mean? Tell me what it was realistic or not. So if everybody's seen it, I had to go see it. I'm going to tell y'all, man, I give it an A. You know what I mean? Like, I think that the hype might have killed a little bit of it because I heard so much about it that I wasn't like blown away like, damn, that's the best fucking movie
I've seen. You give them an A for effort or A for a good job?
No, I give them A for effort. I give them A for good job. Like, cinematically, that joint is perfect. Like, the whole production team on that movie did an incredible job. You know what I'm saying? Like, they should all get big respect for their work. But, like I just said, it was just a solid movie. Like, you know, like, I ain't leave out of that joint, like, making sure, like, man, I got to call everybody and let them know about this joint. I ain't feel like that, you know what I mean? But I just feel like, damn, that's a pretty good movie, you know what I mean? Like what you think about that joint, Lowe's?
It was good. It was good. It was cinematically shot, all in natural light, so.
Yeah.
That says it all. You got to wait for the time of day and everything, and they had a 12-minute cut, so, I mean, that means theater on camera for us.
That's what I'm saying. I just felt like when I was watching the movie, I was just like impressed by the behind the scenes of, you know, because I've been in the industry the past couple of years now. I've noticed all the little stuff of things like that, and I just started being impressed their costumes and all that, you know what I mean? And like he said, the natural light. Like, from what I hear, dog, these dudes practice for 8 hours, they rehearse for 8 hours just to film for an hour and a half a day. You know what I'm saying? Like, see, just that type of artistic thing like that, it's impressive to me, you know what I'm saying? And when you watch it, knowing it did in natural light, that's so impressive, man. That's so much dedication. Like, that director, he did Birdman, which I fucked with extra hard. Like, I fucked with Birdman, so the same director, what was his name again? Alejandro?
Alejandro Iñárritu.
Alejandro what?
Iñárritu.
Iñárritu. Alejandro Iñárritu, you know, let me pronounce that man name right, out of respect, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, man, you did a hell of a fucking job, dog. I give it a solid A. Only thing that I will say, it was weird, it was one scene in the movie, like, he landed in the snow, and they had the little chick, like, hovering over top of him all upside down. Like, that shit looked fucking fake and weird and shit, you know what I mean? I guess they were just like, let me just fill in something, you know what I mean? I guess you can't have it all, can't be all perfect. You know what I'm saying? But that's about the only thing that looked kind of fucking weird to me, dog. But other than that, the bear scene was incredible. Incredible CGI, man. And I think good acting by Leonardo, too, man. Look, it looked fairly realistic, man. You know what I'm saying? I think it looked pretty realistic, dog. So, and especially the joint when they ran off the cliff. Remember he was riding a horse and shit? Oh, man. It's also, too, I'm letting you know, it's going to be fucking spoiler alerts. If you ain't seen the movie, then I'm sorry, dog. It's a Ronnie Lee show. We talking about that shit. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, it was one scene in the movie. Like, he riding a horse and the endings was coming after him and shit. And he went over the cliff. And then that shit just looked so cool how they captured the over-the-shoulder joint like that. And then the
camera fell right over the
cliff. Yeah, the camera fell. That's what I'm saying. Like, as far as the production side of this movie, dog, it was definitely all worth the hype. You know what I'm saying?
Well, what about the animal intestine side?
Yeah, so also, it's a fucking scene in the movie, dog.
They went hard.
Okay, so it's a scene in the movie, dog. Okay, so that scene, too. So, the Van Gogh, he run over the bridge and shit. The horse fall down, break his neck, and then motherfucking neck turned around and shit. So, he fall in the snow. Somehow, this motherfucker got up, crawled to the joint. The man got asshole naked and cut the horse open and slept in that hole, dog. You know what I'm saying? That was some real survival shit. That's probably what your man was like, man, I'm gonna go out in the woods and learn how to be a woodsman. You know what I'm saying? Cause yeah, so it's one scene, so I seriously doubt that shit happened in real life cause any dead animal get cold quick. But your man Leonardo DiCaprio cut the horse open and shit.
Pulled with no lightsaber.
With just a fucking knife and shit.
Yeah.
Cut the fucking joint perfectly, pulled all the guts out. This man stripped asshole naked and slept on a horse in the snow, dog, for like a day and shit. I was like, okay, dog. This man really a motherfucking nature, a wildernessman for real, dog. He's a mountain man for real. It's just certain shit like that, dog. Like, they was very creative in the movie, man.
What about Tom Hardy?
Ed Hardy.
Ed Hardy?
Yeah. Is it Ed Hardy or Tom Hardy?
Tom Hardy.
Oh, either one of them. Hardy from, what's his name?
Mad Max.
The Baron from Mad Max. Incredible job, dog. I think his character was very, very strong, yeah, man.
He played the bad guy really good.
Yeah, he did play the bad guy good, dog. And also, like I told you, like, I'm impressed by other stuff. Like, that dude got a thick-ass Australia accent, and he sounded just like an old country-ass dude from, like, the 1800s, dog. Like, and he played that role tight, dog. Like I said, my overall thing, man, very good movie, very solid movie, but, like, it wasn't a joint that I was like, oh, my God, did you see the revenue? It wasn't like that. It's just like, hey, they did a good fucking job. You know what I'm saying? Like, and to give you an example, like a movie that had that emotional connection with me to where I was hyped about it was Creed. Like, I think I even came on one of these shows and told y'all, like, y'all gotta go fucking see Creed. I think that joint was incredible, incredible movie for real. You know what I mean? So that's gonna be this week's show, man. Stay tuned for next time, dog. We're gonna have more topics for you. Also, too, like I said, in the comment section, let me know what y'all NFL predictions are, man. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram, you know what I'm saying? King Lion Entertainment, you know what I'm saying? King Lion ANT on Twitter, you know what I mean? And also, make sure y'all follow my boy, man, Carlos Lopez Jr. at Carlos Op Repo on Instagram and Twitter, man. And Frontline Productions on Instagram and YouTube. Y'all be safe out there, dog.